Storage of spent nuclear fuel. What we regulate, they're talking about the U.S. National Nuclear Regulatory Commission. There are two acceptable storage methods for spent fuel after it is removed from the reactor core. One is spent fuel pools. Currently, most spent fuel, nuclear fuel, is safely stored in specifically designed pools at individual reactor sites around the country. The other way is dry cask storage. If pool capacity is reached, licenses may move toward use of above-ground dry storage casks. So let's see spent fuel pools. The water pool option involves storing spent fuel rods under at least 20 feet of water, which provides adequate shielding from the radiation for anyone near the pool. The rods are moved into the water pools from the reactor along the bottom of water canals so that the spent fuel is always shielded to protect workers. Current regulations permit re-racking of the spent fuel pool grid and fuel rod consolidation, subject to NRC review and approval to increase the amount of spent fuel that can be stored in the pool. So here are the spent fuel, let's see, these are the dry casks. They're showing here, lined up outside. Okay. Dry cask storage allows spent fuel that has already been cooled in the spent fuel pool for at least 1 year to be surrounded by inert gas inside a container called a cask. The casks are typically steel cylinders that are either welded or bolted closed. The steel cylinder provides a leak-tight containment of spent fuel. Each cylinder is surrounded by additional steel, concrete, or other material to provide radiation shielding to workers and members of the public. Okay, I just wanted to show what the dry cask storage looks like. And spent fuel pools.